Hello, 8th class students. Welcome you once again with another poem, that is The Road Not Taken, a poem written by Robert Frost. Now students, first let me mention you the meaning of The Road Not Taken. It's an ambiguous poem that allows the readers to think about choices in life, whether to go with the mainstream or you go it alone. Over here the meaning is that either you want to cope up with the group of the people or you have to cope up with your own future by your own self. In life is a journey. This poem highlights those times in life when a decision has to be made. You know children, a time comes when we have to make firm decisions. And definitely in your life, one day a time will come when you have to make the decision, and that decision will count your life, whether it is on the right path or whether it is on your wrong path. This poem tells a lot about life in general. Life is all about making choices, whether it is about choosing to change your daily diet or choosing the right career. Every choice has its significance in some way or the other. There will be many occasions in your life when you will be at crossroad and will have to choose a path. Now students, we have an introduction about the poem, that is Road Not to be Taken. It is taken by Robert Frost, and Robert Frost symbolizes about our life. That means over here we have to choose the right path or the wrong path. It decides our future, our destination. The poet gives a very important message and want to give us that the choice which we make has an impact on our future, and if we make the wrong choice, we regret it but cannot go back. So we must be wise while making the choice. Now let's start with the poem, stanza by stanza. We have four stanzas in the poem. All the four stanzas are written on the PPT, as well as the meanings are given and the summary of each stanza is given on the PPT. I'll just summarize the stanza in a very short form, and rest everything you can study from the PPT and go through the poem perfectly. That's what really the poet wants to say in the poem. Now let's begin with the first stanza. Over here, the poet wants to say that on the road of life, the speaker arrives at the point where he must decide which of two equally appealing. Now over here, he's standing on a fork road, and fork road means there are two paths of the road. Both the roads are equal, and it is appealing to him that both roads are equal, and he is deciding which path he has to go. Now you will see in the first stanza that the season, autumn season, has been mentioned. This season over here means that the colors of the leaves are yellow. The colors of the leaves are yellow, and they are being fallen down from the trees. All the leaves are fallen down on the trees of the path, and both the paths where the poet wants to walk, both the paths are being in yellow color. And he examines one choice as best he can, but the future prevents him from seeing where it leads. Now he's standing and examining both the paths, and he's saying that which path he has to move. And he definitely is choosing this path very carefully, because in future, this decision what he has taken will be whether be right or wrong. He doesn't know, but he still want to know what are the pros and cons of this path which he is going to choose. Now come with the second stanza. In the second stanza, the poet want to say that the speaker select the road that appears at the first glance to be less worn or therefore less traveled. Now over here, two roads are there. One is traveled by many people and one road is traveled by less people. So he decides whether he has to go on the road which is being chosen by all the people, or he has to go on the road which he has chosen by less people. So over here he decides that he has to go on the road which is taken by less people. So over here what he says, this selection suggests that he has an independent spirit and does not wish to follow the crowd. That means he doesn't want to follow the crowd. He wants to go all alone. After a moment, he concludes that both roads are equally worn. That means both the roads are same. But he knows that whatever the road he is going to take will decide his future. Even in our life, we take any path or option, but all of them have the same benefits, disadvantages, problems, challenges, and we must face them. We think that we are choosing the better option, but it is not that way. That means whatever we are doing, whatever we are selecting, it should be in our mind, and then afterwards we should not regret that we have taken this path. Now come to the third stanza. Now the third stanza talks about beliefs. That means something, both the roads were covered with the leaves. And how these leaves have come over there? Because it was an autumn season, the leaves have fallen from the trees. And during the autumn season, the colors of the leaves have turned into yellow. And that is why it is mentioned that both the roads were covered with the yellow color. They were in the yellow color. And with those leaves which were fallen on the path, they were describing as a yellow color. Leaves cover both the roads equally. No one on this morning has yet taken either road. So the leaves are lying like that only. Nobody has walked on the both the roads. The leaves lie under undisturbed. The speaker remains committed to his decision to take the road which he had previously selected. Now over here he is very firm. The road which he has selected. And which road he has selected? He has selected the road which no one has gone, or you can say very few people have walked on that particular path. He says that he will save the other road for another day. Now when he has selected the road where less people has walked, so he has in his mind that one day definitely I will come and move on the road which has been selected by many people. He observes, however, that he probably will never pass this way again, and thus will never have an opportunity to take another road. So definitely, though he has taken the decision that he has to walk on the road which is being taken by very less people, and when he was thinking that I have to move on this particular road which is moved by many people, and definitely one day I will come and move again. But he knows once he has gone on this road, will never come back on this road again. So once the chance has been taken away from my hands, never returns to back. So over here, he was having a very equally decision what he has to follow and what he hasn't to follow. So over here, similarly, even in our life, once we choose an option, we must keep on moving ahead with that option, that we never get a chance to come back and take the other option that we had left earlier. Now, with the fourth stanza, over here, the poet wants to describe that. He takes a very deep breath and says that once upon a time, he has reached such a point in the life that there were two options for him, and he had traveled on the road which had been traveled upon by the lesser number of the people. In years to come, the speaker says, he will be telling other about the choice he made. While doing so, he will sign either the relief that he made the right choice or what regret that he made the wrong choice. Definitely, when he has taken the decision that he will move on the road which is taken by the lesser people, in future Either he will be very happy that he has taken the right choice, or in future he may be regret also that he has taken the wrong choice. Whether right or wrong, the choice will have the significant impact on his life. That means whatever you are choosing for your life, you should be very firm, very strong, so that you choose a right path, not the wrong path. Basically, students, this poem is for the students only, because a time comes when students, they take their decisions which leads them to their career, their life, their future. So once you have decided your career, or once you have decided your future, that we have to move on this path, or we have to make a career in this field, so definitely it will make you happy. If you are not doing well in that field, definitely it will regret you that why I have chosen this the thing in my life. This is a very strong message for all the students, that you should be wise and be careful by making the choices out of the options that you have in your life, because your future depends on the choice that you make today. So students, I am going to give you a brief summary of this whole poem, though it is given on your PPT, but once again I repeat the whole summary which is given on the PPT. The poet says that once he was walking down the road and reached a fork. Fork, you know, that is the road. It was divided into two paths, but it was in the shape of a fork. He could walk over one of the paths only. Now over here the poet want to say that when he was seeing that there were two roads diverged and he can only walk on a single road, so he has to decide which is one is the better option, and he choose the option which was less walked by the people. He kept the another one for some other day. Now over here, as I told you in the poem, that there were two paths. One path was walked by many people, one path was walked by less people. So he chose the less path, and he was thinking that a time will come when I will get a time, I will definitely move on the path which was taken by many people. He knew, and he knew very well, that a chance will never come that he can come and walk again on the same path which he has left. He would go further on the chosen path and not get a chance to go back on it. As he walked on the chosen path, he realizes that both the paths were similar. As he was walking on the path, he was realizing that both the paths were safe. He felt that his future depended on the choices that he had made. Definitely, now he is thinking that whatever the choice he has made will decide his future. The path which he has taken either will take him to the right choice, or it will take him to the wrong choice. So over here, children, there are certain notes, though it is not mentioned on the PPT, but I am giving you on the oral form. First one, the road beyond the band may represent the future or the unknown, neither of which can be perceived. Second, year cross uses personification, saying that the road has a claim. Third, personification occurs here also if wanted means desired. No personification occurs, however, if wanted means lagged. Fourth, sigh can indicate relief or happiness. It can indicate regret or sorrow. The interpretation of this meaning is up to the reader. So over here, children, the road not to be taken is a appropriate title for the poem. The title of the poem can refer of either road, and the speaker takes the road which one is chosen by the less people. However, when he chooses the less road traveled, the other road can become the road not to be taken. So that is why this title has given over here, Road Not to be Taken. Now, before that, I end up my this poem. I hope you have understood each and every paragraph. And if there is any doubt regarding with the paras, you can quietly go with your books and go on the PPT. The summary has already mentioned stanza wise on the poem. So please read it. And I hope all of you have understood the poem, The Road Not to be Taken. And with this, I end up my poem. Thank you.